everyone. So this is going to be a quote, quick unquote, review for the Sarkeesian effect, which is not going to be, it's going to be long. I know it's just going to be long, whatever. So if the Aurini version of this film and my review of that was any lesson to be learned, I just need to state up front my bias. First of all, I don't like Aurini. Jordan Owen, is okay, I guess. But for the most part, I don't think anything bad with him. And also, I'm not an MRA, nor am I a feminist. Especially, I'm not a social justice warrior. I see all those like as different sides of the same coin. They're all shitty. They do bring up some good points, but for the most part, it's all just garbage. So I'm not interested, and I'm not even interested in the debate of this. But I'm only interested in terms of Aurini doing this. And since I did Arini's, it's only fair that I do Jordan Owens as well. Now, I went into this movie thinking it was going to be an absolutely terrible movie, and I was wrong. I was actually surprised about how decent it was. It wasn't great. It wasn't good. It was somewhere between okay and good, somewhere in there. There were some problems with it, and there were some really things that I really liked about it. So first, let's get into things that I did like. I did like how, I don't know if he paid attention to what I said about Aurini's cut, or if that was just something he wanted to do from the very beginning, and he just kind of just by accident took my prescriptions. but he took Aurini and himself out of the documentary. Granted, he did narrate it. We'll get into that in just a second, or towards the end of the video. But where they were doing interviews, they were sitting down having a chat. And that was one of the main contentions that I had with the Aurini cut, was that they were injecting themselves into a story where they didn't belong. And a good documentary would just let the interviewee speak and then keep themselves out of it as much as possible. So Jordan did take that bit of advice, at least that bit of advice, either by accident or just he actually did, which I doubt. I honestly think that's what he wanted to do to begin with. But Aurini, I think he said that Aurini insisted that he wanted it to be a buddy comedy. And so he was doing it like that. And now that he was just going along to get along, but now they're not getting along, he can cut him out of the documentary, which is good. So that was a good thing. Taking Aurini out of something is always the best option. Aurini is a self-important piece of shit. He is a pretentious asshole. And when he talks, he sounds like a stereotypical gay guy trying to do an impression of a macho man to make fun of them. He's very fake. He's very phony. Everything about the way he talks is just grating, and it's a chore to put up with. The only person that likes it is Matt Forney, but that's only because he wants to get fucked by Aurini. But, you know, cutting Aurini out of something is always the best course of action. Always the best course of action. So I'm glad he did that. And that will always be a reason why Jordan Owen's version will be better, I guess, because it doesn't contain any Aurini. You know, 100% Aurini free. So that was good. The other thing I thought was really good about this was that they went into some of the dealings that Sarkeesian has had in her professional relationships. She's been involved with a manipulative marketing guru that was kind of really interesting to explain in the context of how she narrates her stories, which I thought was good. There was a part about how she has a business manager of some kind who has had some businesses shut down by the FTC for, let's just say, reasons. I don't want to get sued. There was another thing about how she, one of her associates or producers or whatever, was a pickup artist and wrote books about being a manipulative pickup artist, which I thought was interesting as well. So that was good. And then there was this homage to Ayn Rand towards the end where it was like the John Galt speech. Now, if you've never read Atlas Shrugged, I envy you. There was a part in Atlas Shrugged that was really good called the John Galt speech. And you can look it up. It's actually really good. And a lot of people will say that that's the one part they hated about the book, which I do not understand. It's like the only thing I did like about the book. Where he's kind of explaining, like, you know, how the social justice warrior community are like the church and the social and the Marxists and the collectivists coming down to, like, you know, take everything from the men of the mind who he, you know, which are the gaming developers, that whole thing. And they're sacrificing them on the altar of PC. And it was really good. It kind of ran thin towards the end, but it was really good. And it was kind of a good portrayal of what's been kind of going on. I wish that was the true narrative of Gamergate, but, you know, that was a side part of it, which I thought was really good. And I thought it was really interesting that he would use kind of like the Ayn Rand. And I think he actually used an Ayn Rand quote right before that, which kind of gave me a heads up that something like that was coming down the line. But that was really good. I liked that whole John Galt type speech towards the end. All right. So the bad things was there was some minor editing problems. There was two things that were distracting. There was an interview with someone where the audio was bad and it kind of like had the stereo delay. And then there was a part where he was interviewing this alt porn photographer lady, and for some reason the video just kind of went dark and then went real light again. Other than that, like, nothing was real overly distracting or bad. We were told that, you know, he doesn't know anything about filmmaking or editing a film, but for some reason his film came out more like a film than Aurini's did. So I guess that's saying something. That was really good. I mean, those were the only two things that I really noticed that were terrible. There were some things that were just kind of like, I'm noticing this, but it's not nothing worth, you know, bringing down. There was a part towards the end where they asked everybody what they would say to Anita Sarkeesian, which I thought was just cringe-inducing, especially when a girl writes what said that she should get a real job, which I thought was ironic. You know, like, I don't care what these people would say to Anita, nor do I care what Anita would say back to them or what her reaction to any of these things would be. I really don't care. Now, narration. A good documentary does not have narrators. Michael Moore, Glenn Greenwald, yeah, they made movies with narration, and you could point to them and say they're good, but I would disagree. They're propaganda pieces, because propaganda pieces have that narration. And there are some examples like a PBS documentary about nature where they have a narrator. Yeah, because, you know, you can't interview a wolf and have them tell you the story. So it's important to have it in that respect. And there are some examples where, you know, it was a really good choice in a documentary, but for the most part, it's not at all. And some that come to my mind at the top of my head, like one of my favorite documentaries is called Join Us. What was it? Jesus Camp is the same way too, where there's no narration. They just talk to everybody. And if they need like an expert opinion where they're explaining something scientific, they'd go and ask someone who is an expert in cults or whatever to talk about it for a second, and then let those interviews narrate the story. And there's no person talking over it, telling you what you should think or anything like that. So please, for the future, I don't know if this was something that you didn't want to begin with or whatever, Jordan, but for the next film, let your interviewees tell the story. We don't need you telling the story. Other than that, I thought the movie was okay. I don't know if it was worth $4, but whatever. I guess if you can watch it. I guess it's not a total waste of money. I do feel, however, that Aurini's version is going to be absolutely terrible, and I kind of don't want to be bothered to do it. But I guess just to be fair, I might as well do it when it comes out. But either way, I guess what we can learn from this is even Jordan, who knows nothing about film editing, can still make a better movie than you, Aurini. Worms.